This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Prius. Let's lead the way.
There's a lot of chatter right now in the physics world that we may have evidence that dark matter is sterile neutrinos. Finally, I can stop disinfecting my hands every time I touch neutrinos. Hi there, viewers. Julian here for DNews. There has been no direct evidence of dark matter, only things that strongly suggest it must exist. But now, however, we may be onto something. The European Space Agency's xmm-newton spacecraft has noticed an unusual spike in X-ray radiation coming from the Andromeda Galaxy and the Perseus Galaxy cluster. As our own Dr. Ian O'Neill explains in this article, atoms and baryonic particles give off distinct electromagnetic spectrums, but this spike doesn't correspond to any we know about. So, something hitherto unseen must be the culprit. While the discovery is fascinating, I want to take a minute to explain in depth what he means by baryonic particles, because it's something that links the very, very, very small to the supermassive. Be warned, I'm going to have to explain the basics of quantum mechanics, but learning this will make you cool and interesting at cocktail parties. So, subatomic particles are divided into bosons and fermions based on their spin. The bosons have an integer spin, and the ones we've discovered are either 0 or 1, but they could be 2, 3, so on, we just haven't found them yet. There are gauge bosons, which carry force. Gluons carry the strong force, Z and W bosons carry the weak force, and our old friend the photon carries the electromagnetic force. Then there's the Higgs boson, which comes into existence when the Higgs field is excited. It proves that the Higgs field exists, and the Higgs field explains away some problems of the Standard Model. You with me so far? Okay, good, because it's about to get weird. That brings us to fermions, which have half-integer spins. Now, fermions are divided into quarks and leptons. We've discovered quarks have 6 flavors: up, down, charmed, strange, and top and bottom. How these quarks are combined gives us different composite subatomic particles, some of which you already know. For existence, 2 ups and a down make a proton, while 2 downs and an up make a neutron. These are called baryons, and they react to all 4 fundamental forces: the strong force, the weak force, gravity, and electromagnetic radiation. Because of that last one, we can observe baryonic matter directly through light. That brings us all the way back to dark matter. The theory is that since we can't see it, but we can observe its gravity, maybe it's non-baryonic. Now, if you were keeping fastidious notes, you'll notice the fermion group I haven't explained yet are leptons. Now, we've discovered 3 charged leptons, one of which is the electron, and 3 neutral leptons, which are 3 different flavors of the neutrino. Neutrinos have no charge and are very small, making them extremely hard to detect because they hardly interact with anything. In fact, every square centimeter of your skin gets hit with 65 billion neutrinos per second, but they just pass right on through like listless vagabonds. It's been proposed that there is a 4th flavor of neutrino, the sterile neutrino. It's called that because it would only react to something through a gravitational pull. They don't even react weakly with other matter like their 3 cousins. They'd be almost impossible to detect, but if there's enough of them, they could account for the gravity that keeps entire galaxies from flinging stars off into space, and maybe, just maybe, some sterile neutrinos are decaying and causing this weird spectrum of X-ray radiation. Or maybe they don't exist at all, and I just spent the last 5 minutes scrambling your brain for no reason. Now, if you want to take a step back and review the 4 fundamental forces again so you can get your head around some of this, Trace and I cover that in this video over here. If you've got questions or thoughts on dark matter, I'd love to hear them in the comments. Thanks for watching DNews, and subscribe for more.
This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Prius. Let's lead the way.